Welcome back everyone. So today I will be showing you that how you can backup your Windows 11 or Windows 10 and restore them back. I won't be sharing any kind of third-party tool or software, and you can backup your Windows using the Windows features only. So without any delay, let's quickly get started. Now the very first method is very simple. What you will have to do, you need to click on your Windows search, type Windows backup, and from the suggestion you will have to click on Windows backup, and you will be getting this kind of page that says let's backup your PC, and it says we will backup your info into the cloud and automatically keep it up to date. Have peace of mind knowing it's always protected even if something happened to your PC. And below it give you the detail that what all will be backed up, like your folders, including your files, applications and games, settings and credentials. Alright, so simply you will have to click on backup. Now it says let's sign into your Microsoft account. So what you have to do, you need to go ahead and sign in with a Microsoft account. And as soon as you sign in with the Microsoft account, you will find that it says backing up. So it will start backing up your credentials, your application and files. Now the only limitation here that you only get the limited storage of 5 GB, and if you really want a peace of mind and want that the backup should be automatically done without using any kind of external drive, then you can go with their paid plan, which you can check on their official website. So this is the first method. In case if you want to go with this one, then you can go with this one. If not, then go ahead and close it. And now in the next method, we will be using the external drive to backup our Windows. So for that, you will have to click on your Windows search, type control, then you will have to click on control panel. Now here in the system and security, you will have to click on backup and restore Windows 7. In case if you don't find these options, then make sure that view by has been selected to category. So click on backup and restore. Then you have to click on create a system image from the left in menu option. Now it will be looking for the backup device, so make sure that your external drive or disk has been connected. If you have multiple devices connected, then choose the right external device where you want to take the data backup. Once selected, you will have to click on next. Now it will show you all the information that what all will be backed up. So my C drive has been automatically selected, but in case if you have any other partition and you also want to take the data backup of that particular partition, then you also need to select it. But here I only want to take the data backup of C drive, so I will uncheck this, and then I have to click on next. Now it will give you a kind of preview that says the backup could take up to 29 GB of disk space. So once you are ready, you will have to click on start backup, and the backup process will be started. So this was the second method. If you want to go with this method, you can go. Now let's talk about the third method. So for that, I will click on cancel. And here in the backup and restore only, you will find the file history option that is on the very left and bottom. So you will have to click on it. And here it says file history is on. But in case it says turn on, then you will have to click on turn on to enable the file history. So once it's been enabled, from the left in menu option, you can click on select drive. And choose the drive where you want to take the data backup. Select it. Then click on OK. And once it will be selected, it says file history is saving copies of your file for the first time. Okay, so once it's been selected, you get few more options, like you can click on advanced settings and you can change the setting like save copies of file. So instead of every hour, I would recommend you to go with daily. Keep save version, you can select to until space is needed. Then you can click on save changes. You can also exclude any kind of folder that you want to exclude. For that, you have to click on add. And let's say that you don't want that the document item should be saved or backed up, then you can click on document and choose the item that you want to exclude. Alright, so once it's been done, now this time if I bring up my file explorer and go to that particular drive, so you will find that there is a folder being created by the name file history. And if I double click on it, it will show my user account. And if I open it and go to data, C drive, users, testing PC, so it will show me all kind of my data in the download section. So you can see all the data has been backed up over here that I had in download section, this one. Then we have the desktop item as well. saved games. If you have any, then it will be automatically backed up. This way you can back up your data very easily, and it's really recommended that you should create a data backup in case if anything goes wrong, you can quickly take a data backup. Okay, so hopefully you know now that how you have to take the data backup with the three different methods. Now let's see that how you have to restore the data backup from these three different methods. So first we start with the OneDrive. If you have taken the data backup through the OneDrive, then you will have to bring up any of your browser, and then you have to search for OneDrive. Click on the sign in Microsoft OneDrive, then you will have to sign in with your Microsoft account. And once you are signed in, you will have to click on the setting gear icon that is on the right hand top. And here you will find an option that says restore OneDrive data. Now on my end, it's not showing because I have not taken any kind of data backup, but probably if you have taken the data backup through the OneDrive, it will display over here. You can click on it and restore your data. So that was the first method through the OneDrive. Now let's see that if you have taken the data backup through the file history, then how you have to restore the data. For that, again click on your Windows search, type file history, click on file history from the suggestion, and this kind of box will be up. Now here from the left hand menu option, you will find an option that says restore personal file. So you will have to click on it. Now this will display all kind of data that has been backed up along with the date and time. So you can select the data, so you can choose the folder whichever you want to take the data backup. So go ahead and select them. Once selected, at the bottom you will find a green button that says restore to original location. So click on it and all the data will be restored to the original location. Okay, so this is the second method. And now let's see that if you have taken the data backup through the system image, then for that you will have to right click on Windows icon, click on settings, click on Windows update from the left hand menu. Now here scroll down and you will find advanced option. You will have to click on it. In the advanced option, scroll down and you will find the recovery. You will have to click on it. And in the advanced startup, you will have to click on restart now. Click on restart now again. And the computer will now be booting up in the advanced startup. Now you can also go to the advanced startup from the login page as well. For that, you have to press and hold the shift key and then you have to click on the power icon to restart. Okay, so once you find this kind of option, you will have to click on troubleshoot, then click on advanced option, and then click on see more recovery option at the bottom, and here you'll find system image recovery. So click on it. Now I have not created any kind of recovery image, so it's showing me that Windows cannot find a system image on this computer. But if you have created, it will display you the date and time, the computer name and the location. So you will have to select that system image, then you will have to click on next, and through that you can easily restore the data backup you have created. So that's all guys for today. Hopefully you found this video helpful, and if yes, do not forget to like and subscribe, and I see you in the next video. Bye bye.